worries.
Thank you for joining us back with yet another GMS live stream event with the 7th grade GMS boys basketball A and B teams going against Plainfield Community. I was talking to a few players earlier in the day, and it was they said that they would have a pretty good chance against Plainfield of just having a good game. And after seeing them practice, it looks like Plainfield is pretty in the zone and they're ready for this game, and they've mentally prepared, and they know that this game is going to be a hard game.
Number 21, Lance White. Number 22, Mitch Lukacek. Number 25, Colin Schmidt. And number 30, Kane Vanderbush. The play goes to by Wes Winston and Joe Hoffman. And now we can dance, make some noise for your Greenwood Women. Number 1, Jacob Hornby. Number 13, Micah Davis. Number 14, Jake Mosman. Number 15, Brock Brittle. And number 52, Kay Kelly. The women are coached by Michael Asher and Dustin Asher. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Gentlemen, we are going to face the flag as we honor America with a play of our national anthem.
That was a point by Plainfield number 30, Caden Vanderbush.
Thank you.
Point by number 22, Dury Smith. Sorry, it was not Dury Smith, it was Mitch Chucklepeck. Number 52, Cade Kelly for the Greenwood Women with the last point. Caden Vanderbush just made that point. Looks like Plainfield Community is trying to really push strong while Greenwood is bringing it back, and it's just, it looks like they're pushing, they're trying to push really strong. And Community. Two shots for Caden Vanderbush.
Thank you.
by number 5, Luke Brewer. Number 15, Brock Riddle with that layup. It looks like number 13, Micah Davis for the Greenwood Woodmen, is really trying to push up to that goal and to get those points. Number 3, Eli Ellis with the 3. White for number 5, Luke Brewer. This is the end of the first quarter with the Woodmen at 6 and our guests, Plainfield Community, with 7. Sorry for that, 17 for the Plainfield Community. Said earlier, Plainfield is doing a really good job of pushing, and there are a few players in particular, like number 4, Will Freeman, that just get the ball, and they try and get as close to that basket as they can, and they try to get those points by the end of the
Thank you.
Vanderbush.
You're at half court.
Second period with our Greenwood Women with 6 and Plainfield Community at 19. It looks like the coach is a little mad because it seems like Plainfield is tiring out the Woodmen, and the Woodmen are kind of just letting some of the Plainfield players go up. I know they're not trying to, but they're getting so tired that they can't. By Caden Vanderbush. After the talk with the coach, it seems like the Woodmen are getting a little bit more enthusiastic. Number one for the Woodmen, Jacob Hornbeek, is trying to lead the players to where they need to be to get that basket. Shot by number 32 for the Woodmen, Landon Smith. Missed it, got the rebound, shot it again. And still missed it, and then the Plainfield got the recovery. Blue ball. Thank you. up by Jacob Hornbeek. Shots for number one, Jacob Hornbeek. Micah Davis holds the ball, and it is the end of the quarter. Halftime, grab up, get yourself a snack and a drink, and then get back comfy wherever you are to watch the rest of the A game and the B game. The score is Woodman with 13 and Plainfield Community with 25.
Thank you.
is halftime and 4 minutes and 30 seconds left. The Woodman 13, Plainfield Community 25. It looks like Plainfield is still pushing strong, but after a little talk with their coach with the timeout, I think the Woodmen are getting a little bit more, I don't know how to put this, but like enthusiasm into the game. So they're pushing down, they're doing their best, Plainfield is doing their best, and everybody's just giving their best game.
Thank you.
beginning of the third quarter. The Woodmen have 13, and our guests, Plainfield Community, have 25. Shots made by Plainfield, and then number 25, Colin Schmidt, got the rebound and made it. The same few people, especially Caden Vanderbush, are pushing, and he's one of the taller players, and so you'd expect him to get the ball. Number 15, Brock Riddle, with the two. Number 4, Will Freeman from Plainfield Community tried to stop the ball, but Jacob Hornbeek got it. Two shots for number 21, Lance White, Plainfield. He makes the first one. Now with Plainfield with 30, and our Greenwood Woodmen with 18. Lance takes the second shot and misses. Number 14. Number 14, Jake Mosman got it, and then number 22 smacked it out of his hands and out of bounds. White ball. Travel, number 22. A lot when they're trying to push it up, and then when they go for the layup, they normally try and pass it to Caden Vanderbush or Lance White. Number 32, Landon Smith with the block. Blue ball. Get the number, but the Plainfield have 36 and our Greenwood Woodmen have 22. This is the last quarter. quarter four with 6 minutes left to go in the game. Number 24, Hunter Noel, passing it to number 3, Eli Illis. Eli Illis shot it and made it. It looks like he fell and he got back up and is now sitting out recovering. Blue ball. But he stepped out of bounds in the middle of it. Number 1, Jacob Hornbeek, passing it in. White ball.
Blue ball. Listen to me.
exactly what happened, but now it's white ball. Franklin Community, a timeout. It seems like number 13, Micah Davis, who fell earlier, is now recovering on the sidelines. It looks like he hit his lower back and his head, but he is now recovering.
Thank you.
30, Caden Vanderbush with one free shot. And he makes it. I'm sorry. He has one more free shot. And he makes it. White ball. Smith. Fourth quarter with our Grandwood Woodmen with 29 and our guest Plainfield Community with 42. White ball. Number one, Jacob Fornbeek with the shot. Seconds left to go with the Woodman 31 and our guest Plainfield Community with 42. Stay tuned till after for some interviews. Community with 42 and our own Woodman with 31. There is one more game, the B game. Stay tuned for the B game and then stay tuned till after the B game for some post game interviews.
I'll be back.
I'm getting a drink, so. Hey, Stuart, I'm gonna get a drink. I'll be back.
Thank you for staying with us with our B game. It is just about to start, and I am handing it off to another commentator so we can switch spots.
Just about to start our 7th grade B game against Plainfield. Looks like Plainfield has gotten the ball. Almost goes out of bounds, but is recovered by Plainfield. The ball is back in Plainfield's hands as they take it. Cooper Smith making the shot. Bailey misses his second shot, but with Plainfield running down court to make the goal. Cooper Smith about to shoot his first free throw.
He had me angled down there. The butt was not in the shot.
Yeah. His first free throw was missed.
Yeah.
Hopefully he'll be able to make a second.
Basket.
At the end of the first quarter, the score is Greenwood 4 and Plainfield 0. Maybe Plainfield will be able to score up during the second quarter. The second quarter is starting back up with some new faces on the field.
Side. Go!
Number 23, Trey Rocks from Plainfield side. Scores currently Plainfield 4 and Greenfield 6. Looks as if he's missed the first free throw. Josh Amber, he makes this shot on the Greenwood side. On Plainfield.
Hey, 3 seconds.
what's at halftime with Greenwood at a score of 8 and Plainfield at a score of 4. Maybe Plainfield will be able to come back and win this game, but hopefully Greenwood will just be able to win.
Thank you.
8 on Greenwood and a score of 4 on Plainfield. Number 31, Landon Drennan, has made the first shot of the third quarter. Started back up.
Thank you.
shot. Steal. Only 30 seconds left in the game. Plainfield is taking a lead of 14. Number 10, Max Mint. Making a three-pointer just at the end of this quarter just to get that little bit of points at the end. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, we see Greenwood in one corner with 13 points and Plainfield in another corner with 16. Still with Greenwood at a score of 13 and Plainfield at a score of 16. Game starting back up. Jonathan Smith making it.
Thank you.
Number one, Grady Brown, taking his free throw shot. Looks like he made a second shot. The game continues. Tay Hubbard making his first free throw. We'll see if he can make his second shot. He misses his second shot. Looks like the ball is out of bounds. Shot of the game. Making the shot, Greenwood. Looks like they have taken a timeout.
Oh!
looks like the game has started back up. Smith with this free throw. Will he be able to make his first one?
Yeah.
He makes his first free throw. Let's see if he'll be able to make it. Cooper Smith, ball in hand. No, he needs to get this to be able to catch it. And Cooper Smith misses just by a little bit. Logan! To the goal. Greenwood at 21, Plainfield at 23, 50 seconds left in the game. Can they make it as a comeback? Maybe they can. They've called a timeout at 44.2 seconds with Greenwood at a score of 21 in the fourth quarter with Plainfield on a score of 23. Will Greenwood be able to make a comeback? I don't know. Anybody's game at this point. win this game. Number 20, Anthony Plissner for Plainfield is going to do his free throws. If he's able to make both of his free throws, then Greenwood might be in trouble. It looks like he misses the first one. Let's see if he gets the second one. Looking a little better at this if he wants to make sure that he's going to win. He misses just first one. Looks like they have more seconds left on the score still. 21 at Greenwood and 23 at Plainfield. There's 1.5 seconds in the game. It doesn't look too good for Greenwood. Number 12, Judah Amos. And he makes his first shot. He's going to make this one. Heck of a lot harder for Greenwood to catch it. To catch up. It looks as big with a score of 25-21. Greenwood just falling behind by 4 points. Good game, and thanks for watching our stream. Bye-bye.
Hi, this is yet another interview for our live stream. This is basketball player Logan Blake, and I am Dalton Hawkersmith. Now, Logan, you had a pretty good game tonight. How do you think you did yourself?
Well, I feel like I could have did better towards the end, but I could have made more layups than I missed, but yeah. I feel like overall good.
Yeah, at the beginning of the game, you looked pretty good scoring those 4 points. And then how do you think your team did overall against Plainfield Community?
Good. I feel like we had good ball movement. We did good. I feel like we got back as well, better than we normally could.
Yeah. We all had hopes that you would get back, but you guys had a good game. Now to the next interview with Emma Baker and cheerleaders. See ya.
So, hi, I'm Emma Baker, and this is Elliot Irwin and Maggie Boyce, and they are cheerleaders for the 7th grade team. So, how do you guys think the game went, both of them?
I think it went pretty well. I like how the boys play. They're really good at what they do, and I really enjoy watching it.
I think both teams did really good, and I think we rebounded well.
So, are practices for cheerleading difficult, or what would you say?
Regularly, we just go over cheers and stunt and go over things that sometimes we don't remember or we need to work on, and it prepares us for the games that we cheer for.
And how do you get mentally prepared for these games?
Well, one thing I like to do is not have any bad like vibes going in, and like so don't think we're gonna do terrible. Just think positive and it'll usually turn out positive.
Nice. Okay. So, thank you.
How do you feel about tonight's game?
Thank you for joining us with our live stream with our own Greenwood Woodman versus Plainfield Community. Please stay tuned for our weekly episode tomorrow morning, and thank you for joining us.